address, Mr. Spock?
Difficult to say, Captain. We're getting no registration beam from it.
Look at those pictorials, Mom. Isn't he super?
You know, I think for a 14-year-old, you're a little oversexed.
No kidding. That's great.
Bedtime, Emily.
Hop in. You're lucky I came along. There's almost traffic on this road at night. Where are you from? Not the talkative type, huh? Okay, suits me. But don't mind if I talk up a storm. Listening to me is the price of the ride. My mother says the only thing mobile about me is my mouth. She doesn't know a little boy all that well. I guess it's true. I do go on a bit. I'm an actor, temporarily unemployed. And if there's one thing an actor lacks more than an audience, it's a captive audience. Right now, I'm a courier at the Mandax nuclear project. Spent half my life in a car, traveling up and down, up and down. But a man needs the bread. A lot of people have got funny ideas about actors. Take me, just because I'm not married, even my mother thinks I'm on the other side. She hasn't said it outright, but that's damn well what she thinks. Hey, don't let me scare you.
Found it okay.
Well, if I couldn't, who could?
Come on in.
Thank you.
This is my wife.
Joan, I know. Colonel Carson. Bill Carson, U.S. Marines retired.
We expected to...
Witch doctor with mask and bead.
Where'd you sit down?
Thank you.
Now, how do we start? It's been over 2 months, and the police have gotten nowhere.
We don't even know whether she's alive or dead.
I'll give you everything I've got if you can find this monster.
I'd like to make a few things clear. Whatever you've heard about me, I'd like to straighten you out. You see, I'm not a kind of medicine man. I'm not a mystic. I'm just someone who's been gifted with ESP, extrasensory perception. I ask the same questions the others ask. The only difference, sometimes I get the answer. Sometimes.
Yeah. Professor Johnson up at the university said that you'd helped in cases like this before.
Good old Jake. I did some tests with him. He got a few surprises.
Yeah, but can you find him?
That's all you care about, to find him. Don't you want to find Emily? Find my daughter, Mr. Carson. Please.
I want you to understand one thing. I get pictures in my mind. Pictures of places, people. I want to see Emily's room.
Yes, Emily's just there.
I know.
Thank you.
sorry. This must look like witchcraft to you. But sometimes I get feelings. Vibes, as the kids would call them.
All right, anything. But just help us find... Emily.
It takes time. I have to let my mind dwell on what happened. Then walk over the ground. Visualize things until I'm almost part of them. Until I'm almost him. What we're dealing with here is an aberration of the species. Something hallucinating, evil.
Oh my God.
Terrible evil.
You will find him.
Might be better if I didn't.
Fish and chips and vinegar. Pepper, 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 salt. Don't throw your trash in my backyard, my backyard, my backyard. Don't throw your trash in my backyard, my backyard's full. Ready? Fish and chips and vinegar. Pepper, 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 salt. Don't throw your trash in my backyard, my backyard, my backyard. Don't throw your trash in my backyard, my backyard's full. One bottle top, two bottle top, three bottle top, four bottle top, five bottle top, six bottle pop. Don't throw your trash in my backyard's full. Uh-oh, one bottle pop.
Go. Apart from various abrasions and contusions, I'm suffering from a severe case of frustration. I mean, if somebody pokes me in the eye with a stick, it's not enough to just complain in a loud voice. I'm just about ready to clobber them.
Not according to the text. You just
try and think of these people. Little people. People?
Joe, you've only been here a week. You can't expect to know all the answers. Being a teacher just takes adjusting to.
They're people. What am I?
My cousin, and you better hang in there or I am going to stick Jennifer on you. Got it?
Good. When I have one day I want you to be just like this person. See you later, honey.
Hey, where are you going?
Out, Joe. The teacher, too.
That man again.
Thank you. How'd you like it? I said, how do you like it?
Oh, it's beautiful. It's really nice.
Tell you that
a sense of... I'm sorry.
All right. So what have we got?
Well, we have the obvious clues. The man on the roadside. The plastic bag over the head, like Joan. The common denominator.
Yeah, we know all that. The police know all that. But where is he now?
Now, I sense crowds, bright lights. They fascinate him. He's looking down on the crowds. From a shadow land. He's feeling good. Oh, yes, he's feeling good.
If only we knew what he looked like.
Well, come here. I'll show you something.
Doesn't mean anything to me. I mean, I don't get it.
This is a composite. Yeah. Sort of a police kit. I sometimes work this way. The only thing... The face, I just don't... Well, the face doesn't come to me.
But do you get any part of him at all?
He's less... than a man. And more than a man. Much more. I keep seeing this street, this building. The red letters come through very strongly. These red letters. But I can't spell out what they mean. Maybe a hotel. Or maybe.
May I keep these?
Mr. Parker, let's take a walk. Forget it. It won't bring Emily back.
Might as well ask me to forget my own name. Forget my wife. My child. How is to hold it close? Forget, oh no. No. I have got to find him.
I know.
You understand?
You won't come back.
Someday I'm going to kill that Jennifer.
Triangle yoga helps recovery. Renewal.
I think I could use a little renewal. Now, you tell me why I shouldn't wait up for you tonight.
Not supposed to talk, just meditate.
Talk now and we'll meditate later.
I have a date.
Oh, who's the lucky guy?
You're not gonna like it.
Try me.
Dean Turner. I'm 18.
I don't care. I don't like it.
I'm going.
Fancy cars, fancy apartments, fancy restaurants, and no visible means of support. Fancy that.
I'm not a preschool kid.
It's just that I'm your only relative in the whole hemisphere. Believe it or not, I really do love you.
He's a pussycat.
He's a tomcat.
They're bad?
I prefer cats who work for a living.
I promise I won't let him ruffle my fur until he's given me a bank reference, financial statement, and his credit ratings.
A blood test?
Deal?
Yeah, it's a deal. So what time are you going to come home?
Before I get into trouble? Drive me to the moon.
Do you mind if we stop at my place first?
Lobster thermidor. And that wine.
It was French. I can't pronounce it, I just point.
Oh, wake me when we land.
Take your shoes off.
Get comfortable. My house is your house, as they say in Spain.
Only I don't know how to pronounce
it.
Will you have a drink? Sure you won't change your mind?
I'm sure.
You're looking for the ladies' room. It's that way. Bedroom is that way, too.
No.
You want to tell me about it?
Oh, I'm looking for your visible means of support. You know, when somebody says he has no visible means of support, well, I figure if you do have any, I'll be able to see them. I always thought they'd look like an old-fashioned pair of suspenders.
Ah, you want to know where the bread comes from?
And the caviar.
Back home in Delaware, my old man heads one of those multinational companies. You know, oil, grain, hotels.
Sounds rough?
Sure. I grew up knowing my father already owned everything worth owning in the world.
So you decided to play?
Let's just say I got into a few jams. But my father always bailed me out. He's really a nice guy.
Just a poor little rich boy, huh?
Hey, you're supposed to be a silly, innocent, unsophisticated little girl who doesn't know how to say no.
And you thought you could have my body for a little wine, lobster, a ride in your Scarlatti, and a loll in this dandy double plush car?
It usually works. How about it?
I'd like to inform you in a very loud voice. You fry me.
Why?
You want to know something? You're really kind of soppy. You feel sorry for yourself.
Well, hell, the richest kid on the block doesn't have to be the happiest.
Do you know what you need? Love.
That's what I've been trying to tell you. Come on.
Mother love.
Mother love?
Mm-hmm. Now stay flat in your back. Keep your hands at your side. You're rich, spoiled, and soppy, and kind of handsome. I could learn to like you.
Tell me when I can move.
Not tonight. We have to straighten you out first. Uh-uh. Not a bad start for a rotten kid. I was right.
Right about what?
Pussycat. I can see it all over your face. He was a real prince. I don't know. Kind of a sad little boy. We're talking about the same guy. I'm seeing him again tonight.
Two nights in a row. Come on, we gotta go in here. Here, come. Here,
thank you.
What are you doing?
I'm looking at you through my super-duper spy camera. When I look through the viewfinder, I can see right through your clothes.
You really are a rotten kid.
And when I look into your eyes, I can tell exactly what you're thinking.
Oh, really? Okay, tell me what I'm thinking.
You're thinking that you'd like to have dinner with me again tonight, and but you don't know how to ask, and afterwards you'd like to come over to my place and pick up where we left off. And then you're wondering what would happen next, right?
Not a bad shot, but tonight's out. I have to help Mary with some paperwork for next week.
Get out of it. How about tomorrow morning, early? Look, you don't have to work. I could fly us off to Paris, Rio, Kathmandu.
I know you won't. If you want to see more of me, you'll stay right here. Even if I have to dig a hole and plant your feet. You need roots.
Could you love a man who had roots growing out of the bottom of his feet?
I'd love to come to your place, but if I don't finish this homework, I'm gonna have 63 preschoolers picketing the grounds. Uh-huh.
No, what? Don't go. Tell me something nice.
Oh, I don't know. How did you end up with the greatest looking girl in town? Uh-huh.
The 18th.
Or I guess any time after Daddy finishes his business.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. She's fine, just fine. She's all crazy about some guy.
Uh-huh. You tell her. I can't tell her not to do something that she knows good and well you and I are doing. Besides, I hear it's good for the complexion.
Mm-hmm. Oh, somebody's at the door. Listen, call me tomorrow, okay? I love you. Bye-bye.
Are you really into photography, or is it just a way to get girls to take off their clothes?
It's just a way to get girls to take their clothes off. When my father gets down to his last billion, I may have to work for a living.
So is your father. How come you never mention your mother?
Just an oversight.
What's she like?
She left my father when I was 6. She gave him custody of the child and flew the coop.
Do you ever see her?
Pictures in magazines, along with Greek tycoons, French automakers, and an occasional hairdresser thrown in for good measure.
Must be real tough growing up without a mother.
I really don't remember.
I'm sure he tore the wrong buttons with that mother love line.
I decided to forgive you.
I see the cold showers aren't working, huh? Need a tranquilizer? Bobby? Bobby, this isn't funny. Bobby, is this you?
At this hour. The Chippy's been making a devil of a row, hackles up and all. Janet thought she saw someone prowling around under your trees. I went out to have a look, but he'd vanished. And about a half an hour later, Chippy started up again. This time I thought I saw someone, but again he'd vanished. Anyway, I thought I'd come over to see if you girls are all right.
I haven't seen anybody outside.
No. Well, if you're all right, then.
Thanks, I feel better having Chippy on guard.
Any trouble, I'll be right over with the old 38 special. Well, good night.
I'll be fine. The windows are all barred. Good night. Thanks a lot. I didn't mean to scare you.
I was dreaming.
I saw the light on. Are you okay?
Mm-hmm. How was your evening?
Unreal. Do you want to hear about it?
Some freak's been on the telephone tonight. Heavy breathing and everything.
You? Tonight?
Mm-hmm. Scared me. I keep hearing things in the house or thinking I hear things. I was just about to scream when you came in.
You poor kid. All alone in this big house.
It's not my imagination, you know. Somebody really did call and Chippy across the way kept barking her head off, and Mrs. Stewart thought she saw a prowler, and even Dr. Stewart had his trusty 38 ready to shoot.
Now about my evening. Should I start at the beginning?
You can skip the part about the soup and salad.
Bulldog 1 to Bulldog 2. Come in, Bulldog 2.
This is Bulldog 2. Come in, Bulldog 1.
Enemy position located. Prepare to attack.
I come in? Thank you.
Why? Why have you come back here?
Miss Parker, I came to tell you how sorry I am about your husband.
From the moment that you came into our lives with your smooth talk, you've brought nothing but more unhappiness and confusion into this house. I think you're playing a very sadistic game, Colonel Carson.
A game?
First, Emily. Then my husband.
Miss Parker, what are you trying to say?
Why did you let him go alone? You're a soldier. Or is that also a sham?
A soldier is trained to take calculated risks. I warned him. We didn't have a chance.
There's something very wrong. You're coming here. Your obsessive interest. That little performance in Emily's room. The only positive thing that you've come up with is the prediction of my husband's death.
I hope that I've misread your meaning.
I don't think you have.
I've also come to tell you the time of the demon, our demon, is drawing close.
And your second prediction is also coming true. Did your extrasensory perception prepare you for this?
Competition's getting real tough. I take it you approve?
Green.
Then? Good. I was wondering if this is nursery school.
Special occasion?
Mm-hmm. Dinner and dancing, etc., etc., etc.
Yeah.
Why?
Worried about being interrupted?
Uh-huh. Tell me all.
Well, if it's okay with you, before your parents get back, I'd like to ask Dean over. You know, just cook a little dinner, make it myself, show him I'm a woman, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Tomorrow night?
Perfect. But I don't know if that would work. Your scrambled eggs are lousy.
He'll never notice.
And I'd have to figure out a way to keep Bob awake.
You'll think of something. Deal?
Thank you.
search for you in every, in your veins, yes, even London town. No more will I search all around the world.
Come in.
Bob will be here any moment. Joe, you have a good time tonight. And remember that I will be back before breakfast. Got it?
The greatest.
Good night. Take care of yourself, okay?
Shall we dance?
That's a little strenuous. Remember, we've got to keep going until 2.
Till 2?
Mm-hmm.
God, what are we going to find to do?
I don't know. I told Joe I'd have trouble keeping you up.
Do you have any suggestions?
She said I'd think of something.
Have you?
I'm thinking.
Lamb chops were pretty good, too.
All you ever think about is your stomach.
Sometimes I think about your stomach. You ever been in love?
Once. As a freshman. He was a senior.
The school football jock.
No, he
he was the captain of the debating team.
What happened?
He fell in love with the captain of the other team.
Too bad.
Later I heard they got married. Never even knew my name. How about you?
Oh, well, I've been with a few nice girls. But none that I wanted to wake up to every morning and have breakfast with.
Breakfast? Oh, my God, time for you to say bye-bye. Oh, I'm done.
How about it?
Not again.
No. How about breakfast together? Every morning.
Sleep, you have to drive me home.
Is it time?
No, I'm just kind of worried.
About little Joe's virtue?
I didn't say anything, but some guy seems to be following me around.
Since when?
I spotted him a couple times outside of school.
What do you look like?
He was in the shadow all the time. But he was big. He was really big. That's all I could see. I was afraid of the kids. And then, when I was downtown, I saw him looking out the window while I was shopping. He was looking at me.
Same guy?
And then Dr. Stewart came over the house to tell me that he saw Prowler.
Why didn't you tell me?
I don't know. I didn't want to sound paranoid.
You don't sound paranoid, but you got to be careful.
Joe.
Dean's with her.
But they're all alone in the house.
Let's go.
Till tomorrow?
What am I supposed to do between now and then?
You can try a cold shower.
Thanks. I've got a great idea. Why don't you come away with me? We could leave a note for Mary. Before we went off to get married.
I haven't done the dinner dishes yet.
We're gonna make somebody a great wife. Very clean, very orderly. I love it.
Good night, Mr. Turner. Sweet dreams.
Thank God. I'm sorry. I don't know what got into me.
Looks like your cousin must really have something.
I'm sorry. I feel really foolish.
Forget it. Forget it.
Hey, good night. Thank you.
Hey, do you want to get asked in for a nightcap?
Nope. I want to go to bed so I can look my best on Sunday.
All right. I'll call you tomorrow.
Light out, love. I can hardly keep my eyes open.
The car is still there.
Oh, it's none of our business. For goodness sake, come to bed.
Date. Mary? Mary, you all right?
Coming!
Did you hear that?
Hear what?
Sounded like glass breaking.
Oh, you've been dreaming. For goodness sake, go to sleep.
I tell you, that was a scream.
Oh, that rich dessert, more likely.
Now, what do you make of that?
Make of what?
Take a look. The lights keep going on and off from room to room upstairs.
And they're playing games, dear. I mean, young folks these days like to add a little spice to life. And kinky, they call it. Or wouldn't you know?
That car's still there.
Thank you.